It's the 22nd of March, 2016. Man. It says it's, look at the sun, it says 86 degrees. Ain't no 86 degrees, it might be 75, 74. But the wind out here has been so damn bad. See, he's already knocked something off the porch here. It almost took my solar panel across here and knocked it over. Ow! God! It started rolling that sucker. I grabbed it real quick. I mean, these are things that were up on the porch underneath things and such. Oh, man. I'll tell you what. This man got bullshit's gonna have to stop. I wake up tomorrow and see that plastic out in that field, I'm gonna be so pissed off, it ain't funny. Oh. Man, the wind out here has been, see, we're out in the open here. So, they say, you know, 12 miles an hour, wind gusts of 25. Okay, well that means it's probably about 15 to 20 miles an hour out here with gusts about 35. I mean, most of this is buried around the edges, but after we've done all this work, again, maybe the first week in April we'll come out here and we're going to have to tear that back one up all over again, and we're going to bury one part at a time, you know, like from the middle here all the way back, then the end, and then the same thing over there in the corner to the middle, and then that way I get it, because the wind getting up underneath here, I'm waiting for it to tear it up. It tears it up, I'm going to be so totally pissed off. We got a row of garlic there, a row of garlic there. And again, I had planted onion seeds. I just broke up the ground, you know, just to disturb the tops and drop seeds all down in here. But with the rains we've had, it's washed it all out. So, flowers, there's a line there, you can see the line right going down that way. Those are some large flowers I planted down here, seeds. But I wanted to have onions just like the garlic is there. I wanted to have three rows of onion. They'd be ready, like, I don't know if they'd be ready this fall, probably spring or early summer next year. Like these garlic were planted last fall, these will be ready maybe by fall this year. I don't know, I have to look at this more. But we put six cloves down there. We got six garlic growing up. And then, like I said, we went ahead and did five and six, I think. Five and four, I think, maybe nine. Man. No, I take it back. I think there's six down there. And the two rows I put in there. But, the wind out here has been horrendous, man. I'm telling you what, this is just ridiculous. I wake up and see this plastic out in that other field over there. I'm gonna be, you're gonna hear, well, you'll probably hear me wherever you're at, screaming my ass off, cussing at everything. Yeah, because we're gonna bury that plastic really good. We're gonna go in about, if you see about where that first hole is, where that's coming out over in the back there, about where that cinder block is right there. The dirt will be up to about where that cinder block starts. It's already about 3 inches, 4 inches on the edge of the plastic. We'll go about 10 inches all the way around the edge over there. Got four sets of peanuts over there for four peanut plants. This will all be okra right here. One, two, three, four, about four rows. And one, two, three, four, five, about five deep. So we might have 20 okra plants. I got some flowers down here, and I got all kinds of other flowers mixed in here, too. I was getting the 30s, I think, Thursday night. Tomorrow night. Or not tomorrow night, Thursday night. So what's planted down there, you can see, I'm zooming down. You see that sunflower plant right there. Right in the center there. That's a sunflower. Alright, right there. Right there, that's a sunflower. There's a bunch of them down there. Like I said, this is all going to be flowers all the way down. And then across the back and up the other side, like I've said in other videos. To attract butterflies, honeybees, because honeybees are going to be important for the okra and the tomatoes that will be in the back. That's why we're going to have that back garden. We've got about 14 tomato plants right now, which 7 of them are really good size. And of the 7, there are 4 that are already 18 inches, 16, 17, 18 inches tall. But the wind out here is just too harsh for it still. So that's why I was hoping, I don't know, you can see sunflowers down there. Right there, you see a bunch of them. Let's get this up here. You see those double petals right there? Those are all sunflowers. I got them all around. But then I planted other stuff all the way down too and around this whole garden. I have five deep tomatoes. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Might do 5 back, so it'll be 5, 10, 15, 20. 20 would be 4 rows right here. And then maybe it's 4 over here, so it'd be like 24 tomato plants, which is quite a bit. Oh man, this wind, I'll tell you, it's just unbelievable. But man, God's not gonna win this. Man, God, the satellites, you see that right there? You see that right there is where the satellite usually is, right in that area right there. Look at this, can you see this? I hope you see this really good. I want you guys to see that really, really good. I've done that jokingly, goofing around, and I've had high winds come up and I'm like, yeah, right, man, God. I keep waiting for something from this tree to fall down on my head while I'm coming out here walking back and forth. But you know what? I flip them off just the same. You see? This is for the satellites, because they're up there. You just don't see them in the daytime. Right there, there's one over there. Look at the spray bastards up there, too. Man, those spray bastards. I flipped them off, too. Yeah, see the wind's out here? Probably about 16 miles an hour. Oh! So that's what I'm afraid with this. Oh, you know what I should do? See, I put it up on the walkway there because the sun's setting more. So I'm trying to get it so I can get a little bit of charge for about an hour and a half. I was going to put it up on the porch. I still could. I think I'm going to put it up there. Let me give them all. I'm gonna flip off the birds one more time, all directions. So that's all for this.